Hi, darlings. How are you? This is going to be for my Libras, and this is going to be for the weekend of the 9th through the 10th of September. I will be using my Witch's Tarot deck. And to clarify, I'll be using learning tarot cards. So, Libra, let's see what messages we have for you. So Libra, this is for you. The Three of Wands. You're waiting on some news and you're longing for something. However, you're making progress. The Three of Wands. The Seven of Swords. Now, this could be about new solutions and thinking outside the box. This deck here says it could be also avoiding confrontation. The Seven of Swords. So whatever you're waiting for, it has something to do with the Seven of Swords. It could also be lies and deceit that's around you, okay? Something deceitful around you. Then we have the Knight of Wands. Something passionate. Or maybe some travel. I don't know, but there's some passionate energy. Impulsive, passionate energy. Not too long ago, I mean, you were staying up at night. You had some fear and anxiety. You felt like there's always a crisis going on. The Nine of Swords. But that's past energy. We got the Ace of Swords here, but somehow or the other, Libra, you got yourself all tied up. What happened? A lot of times when the Eight of Swords shows up, we have done that to ourselves, you know? Whatever it is, darling, this is, I got the next card is the Karma card. Honor the changes in your life, and there are positive changes for the future, okay? Always remember, what you give out is what you will receive. You got to think about what tied you up, okay? The Three of Swords here. This is about heartbreak, delays, betrayal. But mainly, I always see this as heartbreak. This deck of cards sees it also as a spell that backfired, but I've never seen it like that. I never thought of it like that, actually. Never know. Y'all don't be doing them love spells. You hear me? They do backfire. No, I don't know nothing about that part, but everything I've heard, you know, I've heard these things backfire. So you guys be careful when you're dabbling with those things, okay? But the Three of Swords, this is some kind of heartbreak. The Justice card. Something may be out of balance in your life here. Okay, or maybe, well, I say out of balance because of the Three of Swords that came here. The Death card, there's a change coming. The World card, there is a change coming. There is a change that's coming. Now, usually the World card is about successfully completing something. So that doesn't say that you're not going to, you know what I mean? There's just going to be a change coming into your life right now or coming up soon if it hasn't already started. And you are aware of this change. You know, a change needs to happen. Not all change is bad changes, okay? You don't like to argue, do you? All right, so let's see. Well, you're going to think of new solutions, I guess. That's how we're going to look at it. Where finances are concerned. Right now, it seems like you have the mindset of lack. Now, it could be the mindset of lack emotionally or financially. But I want to say it's financially because I got the Ace of Pentacles. Or maybe you're just thinking of more ways to make money, you know. Maybe you got to, you know, you just got to make some more. You know, you have a lot, but you want more. And there's nothing wrong with that. Okay, and you'll be manifesting it. Manifest for the collective, you know. So the Five of Pentacles, the Ace of Pentacles, which is some kind of new opportunity that's coming. So this mindset here, this is temporary. This doesn't last long. You got Five of Pentacles, the Ace of Pentacles, and you got the Page of Pentacles. So stop worrying. Don't worry about money. So I tell you all the time, don't worry about money. You worry about money, you're chasing it. Think of how many times things were tight. Stop saying you were broke or you're broke. Tight. You know, stop focusing. I ain't got no money. I ain't got this. Oh gosh, this bill is due. Why are you doing this, stressing yourself out? I mean, in the past, haven't you always made it happen? Okay. All right. Worrying about it ain't gonna solve no problems. So on top of the Knight of Wands here, we got the Five of Cups, we got the Seven of Cups, and we got the Seven of Swords. You need to find some kind of strategy. Or you might be around some kind of underhanded, dishonest person, or you might be doing some risky behavior. Just be careful, okay? I got the Seven of Swords here as well. The Seven of Swords up here as well, where your finances are concerned. So just be aware. The Five of Cups is about sadness, loss, grief. You feel upside down emotionally. Why? I'm not sure. You got some choices here, but there is something dishonest in your environment. I don't know if this past, this energy that came in, this impulsive energy made you do something or make you feel sad for some reason. You know, but you have choices. Always remember that. You got the Five of Cups, you got the Seven of Cups, and you got the Seven of Swords here. This is what you have to be aware of, all right? Just be aware of that. The Nine of Swords is the thing of the past. The Three of Wands. You feel like moving on is a thing of the past. You think you're stuck. That's why you feel like this. You don't think there's any hope. Romantic proposals, they're a thing of the past. Justice card again. You get what you give. Maybe you feel balance is a thing of the past too, but you got the Justice card over here as well. So, I mean, maybe things are going to turn around. Can't be thinking negative, okay? But this is past thoughts. So this is in the past. So we're not going to dwell in them. The Three of Wands, the King, the Knight of Cups, and the Justice card. And then you got something that tied you up. You know, it's something in the past that ties us up. When that happened, and if this is something that continuously happens, you know, this is something that has been going on in your bloodline for years and years and years, and you need to start thinking about breaking these curses. Yes, curses. You see, we learned from our parents, and our parents learned from their parents. And there were certain things that we saw growing up that made it seem like it was acceptable, you know, to be spoken to in a certain way or be treated in a certain way. It's not acceptable. Okay? We should all be respected and loved, not abused and ill-treated. And it's time we stand up and we say no more. Every day I could read a paper from my country and I could see something about a woman being disfigured because of domestic violence. But you see, the thing of it, I do understand sometimes we have nowhere to run. Because everybody know everybody. And it's really a sad situation. See, when I ran, when I was in my situation, I was in the States. And I had plenty of places I could hide. But not everybody is that lucky, you know? So, the Eight of Swords. You got on top the Eight of Swords here. You got the Knight of Pentacles. You got the King of Swords. And you got the Knight, the King of Pentacles. You need to have some kind of patience here. There's an air energy in your environment. This could be a Gemini. It could be you, Libra, or it could be an Aquarius. And the King of Pentacles, this is a grounded person. This is a very stable energy. This could be a Virgo, a Taurus, or a Capricorn. Or it could be you making a business move, you know. Maybe you're the money maker in the family, and you're just making the money, you know. So it could be either or. And this energy, maybe you're thinking about communicating to someone in regards to a business deal. So the Knight of Pentacles, your work is steady, you know. You got it down. The King of Swords, which could be you, or it could be you that make communication with someone, or it could be another energy in your environment, and that's the King of Pentacles. Then on top of the Karma card, you got the Hermit, you got the Two of Pentacles, and the Ace of Swords. Now, the Hermit card is about you going within yourself, whether it's meditating or finding a quiet moment to think about your life and think about you and how you're going to handle certain things. To be centered, to ask yourself the questions that you so want answers to. Take a moment, a quiet moment, and you will find the answers within you. You know, I mean, really and truly, you will find them right here. But you have to look within. And you might be feeling either balanced or off balanced a little bit. But you're adapting to it and you're very resourceful. I got the Ace of Swords. You're going to be having some mental clarity or some communication. So you have the Hermit, the two of Pentacles, and the Ace of Swords. I couldn't think of it. And why is your heart broken? I mean, I do see there's some, you know, you got the Seven of Swords. That's about the most negative card here. The Five of Pentacles, the Five of Cups. Well, you got a couple cards here, sad cards. The broken heart is coming in. It might come from a Gemini. I got the Chariot. I got the Eight of Cups, and I got the Lovers, and the Lovers is Gemini also. The Chariot, it's coming in, kind of bumpy, but it's coming. You're going to have victory. You're thinking about walking away, maybe from the Gemini, or walking away from love, because you got a broken heart. The Chariot, the Eight of Cups, and the Lovers. And Gemini sign here, just in case you wanted to know. So then we got the Justice card here. Well, I see the Justice could be Libra. Is that Libra? Gotta look. You see, I don't really know how the signs look. I'm learning. I mean, I'm a work in progress. Ah, here you are. Okay, so we got the Eight of Swords. We got the Eight of Swords above here. You're feeling trapped, restricted. You got the Two of Wands, which you have choices. You do have choices. You could choose either or. There are two paths you can go. And you got the Queen of Swords here. That could be you, or this could be a Gemini or Aquarius, or maybe another Libra in your life. But I have a feeling this is you. And there is another air energy within your environment that might be a Gemini. But you're a little tied up, and you got to make some choices here in order to find your balance. The Eight of Swords, the Two of Wands, and the Queen of Swords. And there's a change coming. There is a change coming, if it has not happened as yet. You got the High Priestess. You got the Six of... Oh, my nose is itching. The Six of Wands and the Moon. You need to start using your intuition, huh? You weren't given that gift just to sit down on it. You really need to start listening to yourself. You're going to be successful when you really start listening to you. Things will make sense. You're going to have clarity. Right now, you might not be seeing things that clearly. I got the High Priestess. I got the... Or you might be... The Six of Wands is about success, victory. So you might be seeing. Maybe you're going to go within, start using your intuition and start seeing things clearly. I got the Moon. So the High Priestess. So maybe that's where the change is going to come. Maybe you're finally going to start seeing the light, so to speak. You know, from seeing the situation for what it really is. If that makes sense to you, you know? So we get the High Priestess, the Six of Wands, and the Moon. Then on top of the world here, we got the Page of Cups. Now, it could be that you just love being in love. Or you really do need to use that intuition that you were given. You are above your challenges, or you are facing them head on. I got the Page of Cups. I got the Seven of Wands. And I got the Queen of Pentacles. And the Queen of Pentacles, well, the card says could be fertility too. Prosperity. It could be so many things. But it could be you thinking about a business deal. You handling the money. So there's the Page of Cups, the Seven of Wands, and the Queen of Pentacles. Now, that could be a stable energy in your environment. That could be also a Virgo, a Taurus, or a Capricorn. And you got the Ace of Wands. You got new beginnings, and you got new good news. Some creative ideas as well. You got the Ace of Wands here. So life is a little up and down, you know? But I love you. You take care of yourselves, and we will chat soon.